हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी विल स्टडी हॉर्नबिल्स फर्स्ट चैप्टर, द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी बाय खुशवंत सिंह। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज पोर्ट्रेट? पोर्ट्रेट इट मीन्स वर्ड पिक्चर। इन दिस लेसन, खुशवंत सिंह, हु वॉज एन इंडियन राइटर, हैड डिस्क्राइब्ड हिज ग्रैंड मदर इन अ ब्यूटिफुल वे। यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर, this is picture of his grandmother. So in this chapter he had portrayed his grandmother, his grandmother's appearance, her looks, her thought, her daily routine, her opinion about the school, and the way she was leading her life. It was discussed here in the chapter. So let's study the chapter, The Portrait of a Lady. My grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. She had been old and wrinkled for the 20 years that I had known her. She had many wrinkles on her face, on her body, and since Khushwant Singh known her since 20 years, people said that she had once been young and pretty and had even had a husband. So people used to tell that she was young, she was pretty, and she had a husband. But that was hard to believe, because Khushwant Singh had seen her since 20 years, and during this time she was looking old. सो इट वॉज हार्ड फॉर हिम टू बिलीव कि इतनी वो खूबसूरत या उसका कोई हस्बैंड भी होगा, वो उसको बिलीव नहीं कर सकता था, क्योंकि 20 साल से तो उसको सिमिलर लुक में देख रहे हैं। माई ग्रैंड फादर्स पोर्ट्रेट हंग अबाउ द मेंटल पीस इन द ड्रॉइंग रूम। हियर द वर्ड मेंटल पीस, इट मीन्स दैट सेल्फ अबाउ द फायर प्लेस। घर में एक फायर प्लेस था, उसके ऊपर एक सेल्फ थी, उस पर उसका फोटो हैंग किया हुआ था। हुज फोटो? खुशवंत सिंह ग्रैंडफादर्स फोटो। ही वोर अ बिग टर्बन एंड लूजिंग फिटिंग क्लोथ्स। दिस इज अबाउट द क्लोथ्स वॉट एवर हिज ग्रैंडफादर वोर इन द पिक्चर। हिज लॉन्ग वाइट बियर्ड covered the best part of his chest and he looked at least 100 years old. In this picture, his grandfather's beard means जो दाढ़ी होती है, almost उसने chest को cover किया हुआ है। He wore a turban on his head. Turban means जो पगड़ी होती है वो पहनी हुई है, and loose fitting clothes. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest and looking at least 100 years old. He did not look the sort of person who would have a wife or children. He did not look the sort of person, aise bhi nahi dikhte ki jaise uski koi wife hogi aur bachche bhi hongi. He looked as if he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. Aise dikhte jaise उसके बहुत सारे ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन होंगे, बिकॉज इन दैट पिक्चर ही इज लुकिंग 100 ईयर्स ओल्ड, 100 साल के वो लगते हैं। एज फॉर मेनी ग्रैंड मदर बीइंग यंग एंड प्रीटी, द थॉट वॉज ऑलमोस्ट रिवोल्टिंग। द थॉट वॉज ऑलमोस्ट रिवोल्टिंग मीन्स वॉट एवर द थॉट इट वॉज टोटली अगेंस्ट वॉट एवर द पीपल यूज टू टेल। She often told us of the games she used to play as a child. And here, his grandmother used to tell him the games that she played in her childhood. That seemed quite absurd and undignified. And whatever she used to tell about games is absurd and undignified for the writer. On her part, and we treated it like the fables of the prophets and she used to tell us. And whatever the games she used to tell the writer that she had played during her childhood is nothing but like a fables means old story. So for the writer, Whatever his grandmother had told him is nothing but a fables and कौन सी कहानी, जैसे कोई पैगंबर जो पहले सुनाते थे वैसी कहानी उसको लगती है. She had always been short and fat and slightly bent. So this is about appearance of his grandmother. कैसी दिखती थी? Short थी वो, little bit fat थी and she was slightly bent, थोड़ी झुकी हुई. Her face was a criss-cross of wrinkles. Criss-cross means crossing, जैसे cross की तरह जैसे checks हो जाते हैं वैसे उसकी फेस पर रिंकल्स थे. मैनी रिंकल्स वर देयर ऑन हर फेसिस एंड ऑन हर होल बॉडी. हर फेस वॉज अ क्रिस क्रॉस ऑफ रिंकल्स रनिंग फ्रॉम एवरीवेयर टू एवरी वेयर. एवरीवेयर टू एवरीवेयर मीन्स फ्रॉम द होल बॉडी. नो वी वर सर्टेन सी हैड ऑलवेज बीन एज वी हैड नोन हर. हियर राइटर saying that no, she was not pretty in her young age or whatever. So here it was very hard for the writer to believe that his grandmother was once a young lady. Old, so terribly old that she could not have grown older and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. Here writer thought that or is saying that she was so old and terribly old because she had been known her since 20 years and during the 20 years she was as the same age, means nothing was changed. 20 साल से उसको same look में वो उसको देख रहे हैं. She could never have been pretty. Here he thought that कि वो कभी खूबसूरत नहीं रही होगी. But she was always ब्यूटिफुल, लेकिन येस वो हमेशा खूबसूरत रही होगी. बिकॉज ओनली द थिंग विच इज़ ब्यूटिफुल, इट मीन्स दैट ब्यूटिफुल वॉट एवर द क्रिएशन ऑफ द गॉड इज ब्यूटिफुल. नो वन इज अगली. ऑल द थिंग्स दैट आर मेड बाय गॉड इज ब्यूटिफुल. सी होबल्ड अबाउट द हाउस इन स्पॉटलेस वाइट विथ वन हैंड रेस्टिंग ऑन हर वेस्ट to balance her stoop and the other telling the beads of her rosary. Here the word hobbled. Hobbled means walked like a lame person. And student, there is a age in which each and every person cannot walk properly. Means 70 or 80 or more than 80 years old person cannot walk straight. Is it? So little bit lame or they do not walk properly. So hobbled means walked like a lame person. So she used to walk here and there in the whole house in the spotless white with one hand. Spotless white means पूरी जो उसके कपड़े जो होते थे पूरे बिना, means spotless कोई भी दाग नहीं होते थे, वो clean कपड़े जो पहनते थे पूरे सफ़ेद कपड़ों में लपेटे हुए. And she used to keep one hand on her waist. When she was walking, she used to keep one hand on her waist. कमर पर एक हाथ रखती थी. And little bit stoop. Stoop means bent. Little bit bent. Walk here and there on in the whole house. And one hand in her one hand there is जिसको कहते हैं rosary, means एक माला जो होती थी उसके हाथ में रहती थी. And she used to उसको घुमाती रहती थी. Her silver locks. Silver locks, it means that her white hair, L-O-C-K, locks means tuft, जो चोटी होती है वो. So her silver locks were scattered untidily over her pale puckered face and her lips constantly moved in inaudible prayer. Her hair were not combed properly and the hair come on her पैल. पैल मीन्स फीका हुआ जो चेहरा उतर जाता है. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ एज द फेस बिकम पैल एंड पकर्ड. पकर्ड मीन्स रिंकल्ड. सो हर हेयर कम ऑन हर पैल एंड रिंकल्ड फेस एंड सी ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टेंटली मीन्स कंटिन्यूसली हर लिप्स वर मूव्ड were moved in an inaudible prayer. Inaudible means दूसरों को ना सुनाई दे, इस तरह से उसके लिप्स जो है हमेशा प्रेयर बोलते रहते. सी कॉन्स्टेंटली चेंटिंग. यस सी वॉज ब्यूटिफुल. सी वॉज लाइक द विंटर लैंडस्केप इन द माउंटेन. सी हियर देर इज अ कंपेरिजन. राइटर हैड कंपेयर्ड हर हिज ग्रैंड मदर विथ लैंडस्केप इन द माउंटेन. विंटर लैंडस्केप इन द माउंटेन. सो हियर figure of speech, which figure of speech used here? The simile. Okay, I taught you figure of speech in 10th class. So when there is a comparison, when the word used like and is, at that time the compare one thing with other. So here she was like the winter landscape in the mountain, an expanse of pure white serenity. White serenity. Serenity means एकदम से peace, एकदम से शांति. जैसे कि winter में पूरा जो snow से cover हुआ mountain होता है, एक landscape होता है mountain पर, उसके साथ उसको compare किया. Expanse means पूरा वहाँ से फैला हुआ pure white serenity, एकदम से जैसे शांति की वो मूर्ति. Breathing peace and contentment. Here the word contentment means fulfillment, satisfaction. उसके चेहरे पर एक शांत था, एक संतोष दिखता था. So this is about the appearance of writer's grandmother. This is the appearance. Question आता है describe Khushwant Singh's grandmother, तो आप इसमें ये लिख सकते हो. My grandmother and I were good friends. This line gives us a good moral, because today in the present scenario we see that young generation don't like to spend the time with the parents and with their grandparents because they are busy in their lesson, in you know, in mobiles, or they are busy with their friends. So even they do not wish to meet with their grandparents. इवन वो विश भी नहीं करते कि अपने ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स से वो मिले. बट हियर दिस इज़ अ गुड लाइन दैट माई ग्रैंड मदर एंड आई वर गुड फ्रेंड्स. माई पेरेंट्स लेफ्ट मी विथ हर वेन दे वेंट टू लीव इन द सिटी एंड वी वर कॉन्स्टेंटली टूगेदर. खुशवंत सिंह्स पेरेंट्स लेफ्ट हिम इन द विलेज एस दे सेटल इन द सिटी. सो ही वॉज विथ हीज ग्रैंड मदर. ही यूज टू लीव विथ हीज grandmother. She used to wake me up in the morning and get me ready for school. Usko kaun karta tha ready? Yes, of course, grandmother. She said her morning prayer in the monotonous sing song while she bathed and raised me in the hope that I would listen and get to know it by heart. I listened because I loved her voice but never bothered to learn it. Here the word monotonous, it means that in the same tone. So when she was getting ready, writer, she used to speak her prayer and she speaks in a loud way. So she thought or she hopes ke writer bhi usko sune. Writer used to listen her voice. He liked her voice but He never bothered. कभी वो चिंता नहीं करते थे कि जो उसकी दादी प्रेयर बोले उसको वो बाय हार्ट कर ले. बिकॉज ही लव्ड ओनली हर वॉइस, स्वीट वॉइस. देन शी वुड फेच माई वुडन स्लेट विच सी हैड ऑलरेडी वॉश्ड एंड प्लास्टर्ड विथ येलो चौक, अ टाइनी अर्दन इंक पॉट एंड अ रेड पेन. Tie them all in a bundle and hand it to me. So grandmother used to pack writer's bag. और bag में क्या होता था? Yes, slate, yellow chalk, tiny earthen inkpot, red pen, and tie them all in a bundle. एक पूरे bundle में वो बांध के उसको hand it to me. It means that उसको हाथ में देती थी. After a breakfast of a thick stale chapati with a little butter and sugar spread on it, we went to school after breakfast. And what did he eat in the breakfast? Stale chapati, जो अगले दिन की जो चपाटी होती है वो, and ग्रैंडमदर यूज्ड टू स्प्रेड द बटर ऑन इट एंड सुगर ऑन इट, बटर सुगर उसको लगाकर उसको देती थी ब्रेकफास्ट में खाने के लिए. सी कैरीड सेवरल स्टेल चपाटीज विथ हर फॉर द विलेज डॉग. सी दिस इज रियली अ ब्यूटिफुल लाइन. सी केयर अबाउट हर सेल्फ एंड हर ग्रैंड सन एंड सी ऑल्सो यूज टू टेक केयर अबाउट द विलेज डॉग्स, के उसके लिए भी एवरी डेज वो चपाटीज लेती थी. सो इन इन द वे सी शुड गिव दोज चपाटी टू द विलेज डॉग्स. माई ग्रैंड मदर ऑलवेज वेंट टू स्कूल विथ मी बिकॉज द स्कूल वॉज अटैच्ड टू द टेम्पल. एंड हियर सी वेंट टू स्कूल विथ द राइटर बिकॉज टेम्पल वॉज अटैच्ड विद द स्कूल. द प्रीस्ट टोट अस द अल्फाबेट्स एंड द मॉर्निंग प्रेयर. सो द प्रीस्ट टोट अस द अल्फाबेट्स एंड मॉर्निंग प्रेयर. हु टोट हिम? द प्रीस्ट. While the children sat in rows on either side of the veranda, singing the alphabets or the prayer in a chorus, my grandmother sat inside reading the scriptures. Children क्या पढ़ते थे? Alphabets बोलते थे. In the veranda, they sit in the either side. यानी आमने सामने बैठकर they used to sing alphabets or prayer. In a chorus, chorus means group. And during this time, his grandmother reading the scriptures. Scriptures means holy book. When we had both finished, means when the school over or when the lesson over, we would walk back together. They return to together. This time the village dogs would meet us at the temple door. And this time dogs met. They followed us to our home, growling and fighting with each other for the chapatis we throw to them. And whatever the chapatis had been thrown to them, means to the dogs, during this time the dogs started growling and fighting for the chapatis. When my parents were comfortably settled in the city, they sent for us. That was a turning point in our friendship. And here now his parents decided to call writer in the city because they had settled there, and this was the turning point of their friendship. Whose friendship? Writer and his grandmother. उसके बीच में जो friendship थी अब उसमें turning point आ जाता है. Although we shared the same room, my grandmother no longer came to school with me as they settled in the city. Both. Now they are not living in village. Now they are living in the big cities. Though the room was same, grandmother and writer were living in the same room. But grandmother is not coming to school with the writer. That was a turning point. Okay? I used to go to an English school in a motor bus. Now writer had been sent to the English medium school and he was going to school by motor bus. So grandmother ko chhodne nahi aana padta. There were no dogs in the street and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house. Now there were no dogs in the city, so grandmother used to feed the sparrows. Jo bhi city ke house mein jo bhi courtyard mein sparrows aati hai usko wo feed karti hai. As the same year rolled by, we saw less of each other. For some time, she continued to wake me up and get me ready for school. During this time, उसको उठाती थी, ready तो करती थी, but वो एक दूसरे को ज़्यादा मिलते नहीं थे, because writer is busy in his study. When I came back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught me. Now grandmother used to ask writer that what his teacher had taught him. I would tell her English word and little things of Western science and learning, the law of gravity, Archimedes principles, the world being round, etc. When the writer was in village, this kind of teaching did not teach him. The prayers were there, alphabets were there, but as he started to go to school in English medium school, He had learned some Western science and law of gravity, Archimedes' principle, world being round, whatever and whatever, etc. This made her unhappy. And by listening this, his grandmother became upset and became unhappy. उसको अच्छा नहीं लगता था. She could not help me with my lessons. During the village study, his grandmother used to help him. But as he had admitted in an English medium school, his grandmother could not help him in his lesson. She did not believe in the things they taught at the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. She was very distressed to see that in English medium school there is no teaching of God and scriptures. वो बहुत उदास हो जाती थी कि भगवान और scriptures के बारे में तो कुछ बताया भी नहीं जाता, स्कूल में कुछ पढ़ाया भी नहीं जाता. One day I announced that we were being given music lessons. She was very disturbed. To her, music had lewd association. She thought that to learn the music and sing or whatever, music is a profession of prostitute. यानी कि कोई वेश्याओं का वो profession है और ये music जो school में पढ़ाया जाए वो illegal है. It was the monopoly of harlots and beggars and not meant for gentle folk. वो किसके लिए है? तो एक मोनोपोली है और एक प्रोस्टिट्यूट का वो, और या तो बेगर्स का एक कमाने का जरिया है या फिर कुछ उसके लिए वो म्यूजिक हो सकता है, बट नॉट फॉर द गुड पीपल. सी सेड नथिंग बट हर साइलेंस मिंट डिसअप्रूवल. एट दैट टाइम सी सेड नथिंग, सी बिकेम साइलेंस एंड हर साइलेंस इज शोविंग नथिंग बट डिसअप्रूवल. She rarely talked to me after that. उसके बाद तो वो राइटर के साथ बहुत कम बातें करती थी. When I went up to the university, I was given a room of my own. Now they become separated. Now writer has his own room. Now he was no more sharing his room with his grandmother. The common link of friendship was snapped. Snapped means broken. अब उसकी थोड़ी बहुत कुछ फ्रेंडशिप थी वो भी टूट गई. माय ग्रैंडमदर एक्सेप्टेड हर सेक्लूजन विद रेजिग्नेशन. हियर द वर्ड सेक्लूजन, इट मीन्स दैट अलूफनेस, अकेलापन जो होता है वो. एंड रिसाइनेशन, रिसाइनेशन मीन्स विदाउट कंप्लेन. सी एक्सेप्टेड हर अलूफनेस विदाउट एनी कंप्लेन, कि उससे कभी कंप्लेन नहीं की कि वो उसको अकेला क्यों रख दिया. She rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. She rarely left her spinning wheel. Spinning wheel means जो वो यान व्यू के लिए जो होता है वो मशीन. और we can say that radio, like गांधी जी used to play the spinning wheel. To talk anyone from sunrise to sunset, she sat by her wheel spinning and reciting prayer. She used to sit on that spinning wheel and उसके मुँह पर continuously, constantly उसके prayer जो है वो बोलते रहती थी. Only in the afternoon she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrow. In the afternoon she used to feed the sparrows. In the village she used to feed the doe, but in city she used to feed the sparrows. While she sat in veranda breaking the bread into little bits, hundreds of little birds collected round her creating a veritable bedlooms of chirping. Hear the word veritable, it means real. And bedlam means great notice of chirping. Chirping means the sound of the birds. She used to sit in veranda and she gave the little pieces of chapatis and breads to the sparrows. Some came and perched on her legs, others on her shoulders. Kuch to uske legs par baithti thi, some sat on her shoulders. Some even sat on her head. कभी कभी तो head पर भी बैठ जाती थी. She smiled but never shooed them away. They never drove the sparrows away from her body. It used to be the happiest half hour of the day for her. And here writer is saying that it may be the happiest time for his grandmother. कि उसकी जो दादी उसके लिए happiest time होता था because she used to spend the time with the sparrows. बाकी के जो family members थे they have no time to talk with her. When I decided to go abroad for further study, I was sure my grandmother would be upset. And here writer is saying that he decided to go to the foreign for the further study. He was sure that his grandmother would be upset and he would be disliked these things, this idea. I would be away for 5 years and at her age one could never tell. Here this means that he was in abroad for 5 years and he was sure that कि 5 साल के बाद जब वापस आएंगे तब उसकी grandmother शायद नहीं रहेगी because she was too old. But my grandmother could. लेकिन उसकी grandmother 5 साल तक थी. She was not even sentimental. Sentimental means emotional. She was no more emotional. She came to leave me at the railway station but did not talk or show any emotions. Even she went with the writer to the railway station to bid him, to give him or say him goodbye. But at that time there were no emotions on her face. Her lips moved in prayer. Her mind was lost in prayer. During this time, there were no emotions on her face. She was constantly saying the prayer and constantly chanting, and she was lost in the prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. उसकी जो fingers थे वो continuously rosary मतलब माला जो होती है वो ही घुमाते रहते थे और chanting करते रहते थे. Silently she kissed my forehead and when I left I cherished the most moist imprint as perhaps the last sign of physical contact between us. Here writer was so happy that this was a physical contact between them. कि उसको उसके touch किया, उसको kiss किया उसके forehead पर और वो उसके लिए imprints means एक last और most important impression उसके दिमाग पर रह जाती थी कि उसकी दादी ने उसको प्यार से उसको forehead पर kiss किया. Here the word cherished, it means that hold something with dear. But that was not so. After 5 years, I came back home and was met by her at the station. Writer returned. He had completed his study in abroad. After 5 years, he returned and he saw that his grandmother was there on the station. She did not look a day older. Means, एक दिन की जितनी भी वो ओल्डर हुई हो उतना नहीं लगता. सी वॉज एज ओल्ड एज सी ही हैड सीन हर बिफोर 5 years. सी स्टिल हैड नो टाइम फॉर वर्ड्स एंड वाइल सी क्लैप्स्ड मी इन हर आर्म्स आई कुड हियर हर रिसाइटिंग हर प्रेयर्स. इवन जब वो मिले तब भी उसको ऐसा लगता था कि उसकी दादी जो है सी वॉज रिसाइटिंग द प्रेयर्स. इवन On the first day of my arrival, her happiest moments were with her sparrows whom she fed longer and with frivolous rebukes. Sometimes she rebukes to the sparrows. कभी कभी वो sparrows को rebuke मतलब थोड़ा डांट भी देती थी. But here writer found that she was not happy to meet the writer. But she was happy. And she used to spend the happiest time with the sparrows. कि वो इतना मिलकर means उसको इतना मिलकर वो खुश नहीं हुई जितना कि वो sparrows के साथ अपना time बिताती है तब खुश होती है. In the evening a change came over her. On the same day there was a change in her. She did not pray. वो prayer भी नहीं कर रही थी. She collected the women of the neighborhood. Got an old drum and started to sing. She collected and gathered the neighbor ladies and she started टू बीट द ड्रम एंड स्टार्टेड टू सिंग. भगवान के जो स्क्रिप्चर्स और कुछ भजन कीर्तन है वो गाना शुरू हो जाता है. फॉर सेवरल आवर्स सी थम्ड द सेगिंग. थम्ड इट मीन्स दैट बीट स्ट्रोंगली, जो ड्रम होते हैं उसको स्ट्रोंगली वो बीट करने लगे. एंड द सेगिंग, सेगिंग मीन्स सिंकिंग डाउनवर्ड्स. फॉर सेवरल आवर्स, कुछ घंटों तक वो ड्रम्स को बीट करते रहे. सी थम्ड द सेगिंग स्किन ऑफ द डिलेपिडेटेड ड्रम. वो इतना ड्रम को बजाते रहे कि ड्रम का कुछ पार्ट जो होता है वो भी रुइन हो जाता है, टूट जाता है. सो स्किन ऑफ द डिलेपिडेटेड ड्रम एंड सेंग ऑफ द होम कमिंग ऑफ वॉरियर्स. जैसे कि वॉरियर्स जो होते हैं घर वापस आते हैं तब कैसे वो बजाते, इस तरह से वो बजाकर वो गाने लगे. वी हैड टू परस्यूएड, परस्यूएड मीन्स फॉलोड. वी हैड टू फॉलोड हर टू स्टॉप टू अवॉइड ओवर स्ट्रेनिंग. दैट वॉज द फर्स्ट टाइम सिंस आई हैड नोन हर दैट सी डिड नॉट प्रे. राइटर हैड नोटिस्ड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट ग्रैंड मदर वॉज नॉट प्रेइंग. द नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग सी वॉज टेकन इल. इट वॉज अ माइल्ड फीवर एंड द डॉक्टर टोल्ड अस दैट इट वुड गो. मीन्स डॉक्टर सेड दैट इट्स ओनली अ माइनर फीवर एंड इट विल बी गॉन. बट माई ग्रैंड मदर थॉट डिफरेंटली. शी टोल्ड अस दैट हर एंड वॉज नियर. सी सेड दैट सिंस ओनली अ फ्यू आवर्स बिफोर द क्लोज ऑफ हर लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ हर लाइफ सी हैड ओमिटेड टू pray. She was not going to waste any more time talking to us. And grandmother said that her death was near. And even she told that she did not want to waste the time talking with the family members. She wanted to recall and remember the God. वो भगवान को याद करना चाहती थी. She did not want to waste her time. We protested. हमने उसका विरोध किया family member ने. But she ignored our protest. She avoided and उसको ignore करती है उसका protest का. She lay peacefully in bed and praying, telling her beads. वो अपनी माला जो है वो घुमाती है और भगवान का नाम लेती है. Even before we could suspect, her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. अ पीसफुल पैलर स्प्रेड ऑन हर फेस. जैसे कि एक उसके पैल फेस, जो फीका हुआ फेस था उस पर जैसे एक लाइफलेस जैसे बन गया, जैसे उसके चेहरे पर कोई जीवंत जो चेहरा है वो दिखाई नहीं दिया. हर सी बिकेम लाइफलेस और वॉट एवर उसके हाथ में जो वो रोजरी थी वो भी गिर जाती है. एंड हियर द फैमिली मेम्बर वी न्यू दैट सी वॉज डेड. और इस तरह से उसको पता चल जाता है कि उसकी जो ग्रैंड मदर है सी वॉज डैड. वी लिफ्टेड ऑफ द बेड एंड एज इज कस्टमरी लेड ऑन द ग्राउंड एंड कवर्ड हर विथ अ रेड श्राउड. श्राउड मीन्स क्लोथ. बिकॉज वेन देर इज अ लास्ट मोमेंट और वेन देर इज अ क्रिमेशन, जब क्रिमेशन के लिए लेकर जाते अग्नि संस्कार के लिए, तब फ्लोर पर उसको लेटाते. कुछ कस्टमरी मीन्स कुछ विधियाँ होती है, कस्टम्स जो होती है रीत रिवाज के अकॉर्डिंग. शी पुट ऑन द ग्राउंड एंड हर डेड बॉडी वॉज कवर्ड विद द रेड श्राउड. आफ्टर अ फ्यू आवर्स ऑफ मॉर्निंग वी लेफ्ट हर अलोन टू मेक अरेंजमेंट्स फॉर हर फनरल. फनरल मीन्स उसको जो जलाने की जो विधि होती है, अंतिम संस्कार होता है उसके लिए उसको तैयारी करती है. दे बिकम रेडी फॉर द फनरल. In the evening, we went to her room with a crude stretcher to take her to be cremated. Cremated means अग्नि संस्कार जो होता है. Funeral means जो उसकी अंतिम यात्रा होती है वो. And cremated मतलब अग्नि संस्कार के लिए उसको stretcher पर लेटाया जाता है. Stretcher means जो last moment पर जिस पर उसको सुला कर लेकर जाते हैं, that things. So crude, here the word crude means roughly made. The sun was setting, had lit her room and veranda. with a blaze of golden light. And here in the evening, the picture was amazing. क्योंकि उसकी जो sun की जो sunset के वक्त उसका golden जो light होती है उसके पूरे room पर आता है. We stopped halfway in the courtyard. All over the veranda and in her room, right up to where she lay dead and stiff, wrapped in the red shroud, thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. And here the scene was like that, कि जब उसको वरंडा पर स्टॉप करते हैं, ये भी एक कस्टम में आता है, एक घर के बाहर स्टॉप करते हैं, एक जो घर का विलेज का एक जो मेन एरिया होता है वहाँ पर स्टॉप होता है, और एक जो स्टॉप होता है तीसरा और चौथा कुछ स्टॉप आता है वो होता है श्मशान. तो दिस इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ कस्टम. सो व्हेन दे स्टॉप्ड इन द वरंडा द स्पेरोज वर स्कैटर्ड देयर. कितनी सारी स्पेरोज वहाँ पर आई थी. देर वॉज नो चिरपरिंग हियर. द स्पेरोज वर साइलेंट. दे वर नॉट चिरपरिंग. वी फेल्ट सॉरी फॉर द बर्ड्स एंड माई मदर फेच्ड सम ब्रेड फॉर देम. She broke it into the little crumbs. Crumb means small pieces. The way my grandmother used to, and threw it to them. And here, writer's mother had given some pieces of the breads to the sparrow in the same way as his grandmother used to give them. The sparrows took no notice of the bread. Lekin, bread par kisi ne dhyan diya nahi. Sparrow did not give any notice to the breads, because as like human being, also animals and birds have the emotions. They feel, though they cannot speak, but yes, definitely they can feel. When we carried my grandmother's corpse off, corpse corpse means dead body of human being, they flew away quietly. So when the dead body of the grandmother had taken away, the sparrows flew away quietly. Next morning, the sweeper swept the bread crumbs into the dustbin. Next day, sweeper came and threw that crumbs means pieces of bread into the dustbin. Student, I am giving you homework. You have to make 200 pages book. Agar 100 pages ki bana li ho, to please 200 pages ki bana lena. In which you have to write first you have to write the vocabularies, and then you have to write the question and answers. Understanding the text question 1 to 5, talking about the text question 1 to 4, and thinking about language question number 1 to 4. These are the question and answer that you have to write in your notebooks. Thank you and have a nice day.